Today's discussion of my topic is Nikah or marriage under the Muslim personal law. Now, what is Nikah? Nikah means, generally we say that Nikah is an legalizing the sexual relationship, and by implication it is a contract of marriage. So when you are legalizing the relationship, then it is become a contract of marriage. Now, on Nikah, there is an eminent author called Amir Ali. He has pointed out that Nikah is an institution ordained for the protection of society and in order that human beings may guard themselves from foulness and unchastity. Now, he said that it is an institution and it is required for the protection of society and in order that human beings may guard themselves from foulness and unchastity. So it is by an institution called Nikah, we can only guard themselves from foulness and unchastity. That is why, in his opinion, he said Nikah is very much important and for the protection of the society. Now, we have to see what is the object of Nikah or marriage under the Muslim personal law. The first object is, we said, the legalizing the sexual relationship. And secondly, it is a ordering of social life. So by Nikah, we can have an ordered social life. And third is to the legitimization of children. So by Nikah itself, we can give a legitimate status of the children. Otherwise, it cannot be called as a legitimate, but that there will be a illegitimacy of the illegitimate children born out of the relationship. And the fourth one is the legalization of cohabitation. Now, person may be cohabit each other, then they will not have any legal status like husband and wife. So to legalize that cohabitation, we required Nikah. So there must be a Nikah or marriage under the Muslim personal law. So this is the object behind it, to have the Nikah. So Muslim personal law, this says the marriage or Nikah is a civil contract. So this is a modern day concept. So it is a civil contract. When it is a civil contract, we have to see there are provisions of the Indian Contract Act that must present in that Nikah or the marriage. Now, what are the essential elements of a marriage? The first essential elements we require, there must be an offer and acceptance. Now, what is offer or proposal? It is called izab, and acceptance is called kubul. So, there must be an proposal or izab from one party and acceptance or kubul by the other party. So, there are two parties required, and this proposal and acceptance or kubul must be present. That will be called as an essential elements of a valid marriage or the Nikah. Secondly, it is capacity to contract marriage. When you say about capacity to contract marriage, it is a capacity, that is, he must be of sound mind, he must be a major. What is major? He must be major according to the Indian Majority Act. So majority, age of majority, we said 18 years for girl and 21 years for boy. This is according to the Indian Majority Act. So that is also, we have a concept called puberty under the Muslim personal law. Instead of age of majority, we said it is a puberty. Now that is why the capacity to contract marriage, we are going to elaborate this point, because there are two religious sects are there, Shia and Sunni. So the age of puberty or age of majority is varies as per the Muslim personal law. So that is why we have to discuss in a length of this age of puberty, that is a capacity to contract marriage. The third essential element is the considerations. A consideration as per the Indian Contract Act, we see that something in return. For the valid Nikah, we must have a considerations. Now, what is consideration as per the Muslim personal law? So it is a consideration that is called mehar or the dower. So mehar or dower must be present in a marriage, then and then it will have a valid Nikah. Now that meher or the dower also have a very big chapters we are having. So in my next lectures I will discuss about the what is meher or dower. So there are different kinds of meher or dower is also there. But at this initial point we have to only see what are the essential elements we require to have a valid nikah or the marriage under the Muslim personal law. And the next point is we said it is a contract. So when you say about contract, then there must be a provisions for the marriage can be dissolved or divorce or talaq. The provision must be there because it is a contract. So there is a likely to have a marriage could be broken or dissolved. Next is a documentation. It is also very very important to have a valid nikah because without documentations we cannot have a marriage. So that is called nikah nama. And the last point of the essential elements is that there must be a presence of two witnesses. So two witnesses is very very important. So one witness may be from one party, other one from the other party, that is who is giving a acceptance of the couple. So two persons must be there, and also we require that qazi must be present at that point of making a contract of nikah. Then what is capacity to contract we are discussing now? So capacity contract means first point we have to see he should be of sound mind, and he should have attained the age of puberty. So sound mind, that means he is capable of understanding the cause and consequences, and he must attain the age of puberty. So what is age of puberty? We must define the term puberty now. So age of puberty means the age of majority. A Muslim can attain the age of majority even before age of majority, that means age of puberty. As per Muslim law we said age of puberty. So even before attaining the age of majority, so that is why we have to distinguish it, what is age of puberty and age of majority. As I said, 18 years for girls, but here we said even before attaining the age of majority there could be an age of puberty. Now age of puberty, again we are saying puberty means the period of life at which the person become capable of begetting or bearing children. So puberty means what? It is a period of life begins. Why we said life begins? Because he can or she can have the capacity to have the children. That is called bearing children. So that is the period they are saying it is the age of puberty. Because she can capable to have a children. That's why it is the age of puberty. So that's why we said age of puberty may attain before attaining the age of majority. Now we have to see in Indian situation. In India, the age of puberty may be of 13 years and 14 years is the age of puberty for a girls. Why you say it's age of 13 and 14? Because age of 13 and 14, the girls may become matured. That is the period or menstruation the girls attains. That is why we say 13 or 14 years may be the age of puberty. But this is not the age of majority as per the Indian Majority Act, because that is 18 years. Now according to Sunni law, that is a sect, that is a religious sect, that is Sunni, says the boy and girl attain the age of puberty after the completion of 15 years. So both boys and girls will attain puberty after completion of 15 years. So they should attain the age of 15 and they will become an age of puberty. So age of puberty, that means they might have obtained the age, that is they are capable of having children or capacity to be a bearing or begetting children, that is they are presuming or assuming as age of puberty as per the Sunni law. Now Shia says that is why the age of puberty even say this after completion it is a 15 years, that means they are quite mature to have their own children also. That's the age of majority they are judging as per the Sunni law. But Shia law, they said age of the girl age of the girl becoming the age of the girl who obtains or who gets the period of menstruation begins, which will be before the age of 12 years. As per she has said that the girls, the moment she will attain the age of menstruation, so that will be the period for the age of puberty as per the Shia law. Now this is the age even before 12 years. Maybe some girls obtain or get the stage of getting a menstruation period. So that is why the Shia says puberty begins maybe at the age of 12 years. A Muslim minor can contract marriage through his guardians. If even the minor girls, they wanted to get married, they can marry through guardians. Because why we said minor? Because the age of majority is 18 years. Now when we said about 15 years is the age of puberty and 12 years is the age of puberty, then this is somehow it is very conflicting on this point, that because age of majority is 18 years, as per the all other sentiments, but here we said it is a 15 and 12. So that means what? The girls, moment they will obtain the age of maturity, that is a menstruation period when they will start, they can have their age of puberty. So that is why at that time of period, as per the Indian majority, we said they are not marriageable age. But as per the Muslim personal law, they are called as a marriageable age. So that's why we say that at that time, the puberty age, they can get married through his guardians. And option of puberty, there is one concept here. We have seen already what is puberty, but we have to go for an option of puberty. That is age of majority and age of puberty, there is an option is given. Even in the Indian Hindu marriage act, even we have the option is given, the option of the age of majority we have. But here option of puberty we are talking about. If a Muslim minor is married to guardians even before attaining the age of puberty, then an option has been provided. Now what we say that option of puberty, a Muslim minor is married to a guardians. To a guardians means somebody will be there as a guardians who can give the marriage of the girl. And when they have given the marriage, before attaining the age of majority or age of puberty. So age of puberty, here we said, it is what age of puberty means, before she attained the age of 18 years. So that is the age of puberty is given. So then that time there is an option has been provided to them on attaining the age of puberty, then they can either ratify the marriage or repudiate it. So that period of time, the girl can, if wants to repudiate the marriage, she can, or if she wanted to continue the marriage on the after attaining the age of puberty, she can do it. So this is an option is given. Two options is given, either on attaining majority or that is attaining puberty, she thinks that this marriage is okay for her, she can continue. Or if she thinks that no, before attaining the age of puberty, I have been given for a marriage, so I don't want to continue this marriage, so she can have an option to repudiate the marriage. So this is the option is given for the Muslim personal law as per the nikah institutions. Now as per section 2.8 of the dissolution of the Muslim marriage in 1939, a wife is entitled to have the dissolution of her marriage. She can dissolve the marriage, but there is a certain fact she has to prove it. That she has to say that her marriage is given by her guardians when she was minor. She can have this fact that she said that she has been given a marriage by her father because at that time she was minor. And second thing is, she has to prove it here that she has not been given a consent that marriage has been consummated. She said her marriage has not been consummated. So that means consummation means her marriage has not took place. That means the that is relationship between the husband has not been taken place. So she has to prove these two things, these two facts. She has to prove it. On these two grounds, she can dissolve her marriage under Section 28 of the Dissolution of the Muslim Marriage Act 1939, because she had given a marriage to a guardian. At the time of marriage, she was a minor. Even she has not attained the age of puberty. So she could prove these facts and she can dissolve the marriage. This is the option is given to a Muslim girl or a wife under the Muslim personal law on the concept called nikah. Then she can also say that the marriage took place before attained the age of 15 years. She can say that my marriage has been took place before the age of 15 years. So 15 years, why we say it? Because as per the Sunni say that the boy and girl attain the age of puberty at the age of 15 years. So she can very well prove that my marriage has been taken place before the attaining the age of 15 years. So I have not attained the age of 15. And also she can say that the next point is an important. She has repudiated the marriage before the attainment of 18 years. So this point also she can raise and can have a dissolution of the marriage. She said that she has repudiated the marriage before attaining the age of 18 years. So she is very well safe on this point that 18 years is a marriageable age as per the Indian Majority Act, and she could prove that I have cancelled, that means repudiated the marriage, means cancelled the marriage before attaining the age of majority, that is of 18 years. And even option should be obtained by the wife immediately after attaining the age of puberty. When you have an option, these are the grounds. If you can prove before the court, you can very well get your dissolving the marriage as per the Muslim Dissolution Act 1939. So you have to say that the last point is important, that she should exercise this right immediately after attaining the age of puberty. So the moment you have attained the age of puberty, so you should not wait for the next day. Immediately you should exercise the right to dissolve the marriage. There was one case, Ajiz Banu versus Muhammad. In this case, the court has held that a Muslim girl married to a Muslim girl is right, but her sect was a Shia, and she married to a Sunni boy, has a right of puberty only on the ground she can exercise the right of puberty over here, and on this ground that the marriage is repugnant to his religious or her religious sentiments, provided the marriage is not ratified or consumed. So in this Aziz Banu versus Muhammad, here the court wanted to prove that there are two different sects there, and it is against their religious sentiments. Okay, so on this ground they can prove it, that it is repugnant to her religious sentiments, because she is a Sunni and she is a Shia, and she got married to a Sunni, so it is going against her religion. Okay, this ground she can prove it, but provided that she has to also say that my marriage is not ratified or consumed. Important thing is there, marriage is not ratified means she has not confirmed or affirmed a marriage, and also she said that marriage has not took place. That is, consummation means there was no relationship between her and her husband. So if this grounds she could prove, then in this case that very well the girl could succeed at her marriage dissolution on the ground of that option of poverty. So this is to say that your religious sentiments you can prove in a case, but also you have to prove very well that one of the grounds which is laid down under the dissolution of the Muslim wife under the act called Muslim Dissolution of the Muslim Marriage Act 1939, they were very well established that ground, and one of the grounds she said that she has an option to ratify. If you ratify it, fine. If you do not ratify, then very well you can establish that this is your case under the grounds laid down under the 2(8) of the 39 Act, that is of Dissolution of the Muslim Marriage Act. And consummation is also very important, because unless and until your relationship took place between you and your husband, then there will not be a marriage. And it is this, on this point, there is also important term called mehar or dawar is also based. So this is a consummation word in this nikah, is a very, very important concept, and it is relying on the very different facts are depending on this consummation of the marriage, and it can be proved before the court.